Okay guys, I'm back out here in my honey hole. I had to redo my video because my camera wouldn't let me, I mean, my phone wouldn't let me turn my camera, so pretty much all you get. This morning, I got in staying late. As I was coming back here, about 100, 150 yards out from my stand, I had a deer standing out or walking kind of toward my stand. I didn't know what it was. Thought it was just a doe, you know, gonna just spook her out and wouldn't hurt nothing. Well, come to find out, I thought it was a little buck, so I was like, okay, you know, a little buck, ain't no big deal. Well, that little buck turned into about 150 inches, 145, 150 inch, whatever. A big enough buck that I would have shot him. But what happened was, as I'm sitting there watching, trying to catch him to where he can't see us to move up here as close as we can. Yeah. He ended up walking from clear to that little opening over here. There's a little opening. He walked all the way straight up from my stand to about right there at the edge where I've got it mowed to the edge of him standing corner. Walked all the way down here so far. And as I was moving, he caught us moving, didn't know what it was, didn't blow, didn't spook or nothing. He just kind of walked off. He walked all the way down through in here and around here somewhere. But I'm doing an all day set pretty much here in my honey hole because I've killed many deer out of this spot within the last couple of years, more than anywhere else I've ever killed them. But yeah, I mean, you can see pretty much everything. Just a few deer, I mean, a few squirrels all day. One coyote. My cousin didn't shoot him, I got onto his butt. But yeah, I mean, I'm hunting right at the edge of a property line. I'm still waiting to get permission to hunt it because I ain't hunted it yet. The only thing that separates that property line, there's a fence post. Might not be able to see it, but there's a fence post down there somewhere. If you might be able to see it right in there somewhere, there's a fence post that separates the property line and my tree, and the tree that I'm sitting in just happens to be not even a foot on the on my cousin Joe's. I'm out here hunting him as I usually do. But I mean, deer are plentiful out here. And if you can look right there, there's a little twig in that Y. That's the one I ended up hitting when I was shooting my doe back on October 8th when I shot her. Instead of hitting behind the shoulder where I wanted it, it hit back of the gut, went up in, hit her liver and hit her lungs and come out the back side of her right shoulder. And she ran, did a big old U out through there. Let's see if I can zoom back out, or back in, out a little bit instead of zooming in. Did a big old U, went right over in there, in that clearing that I've got mowed and stuff over there, died. But this year, I got a whole new setup, kind of somewhat of a whole new setup. New arrows anyways, new string, superior string for sure. Got a whole new knot, or a whole new peep tubing. I know most people don't use them, but I require it because it's easier for me to not have to worry about adjusting my peep. My arrows here are Carbon Express Mutinies 350s with they're actually 340 grain spine, even though they say 350, but they're actually 340 grain spine. I got a nocturnal blue lighted nog, my quiver. I've got a couple Lumnox in there and two more nocturnals. Every one of them is tipped with rage. This one here, that one, original three blade rage. I've shot a couple of deer with them, still have my broadheads. All I do is just change out the blades and be done. I have a trophy, whoops, I have a Trophy Ridge 5-pin sight called the Volt. Got a True Glow sight light, so I can use it for when these big boys or does or whatever want to decide to come in. But we're doing an all-day set, and what we're going to do is, my cousin, since he gets back in, he should be, yeah, he's walking out across the field now. I don't know if you can see him in the video. And he had to go get his soda and my soda and his crackers to do an all-day set. But I've been rattling with his rattle bag, been grunting, and used my binoculars, and it's getting hot, so I took off my hoodie there, my camo hoodie I bought to help out instead of wearing a heavy coat all the time. It's kind of light enough that I don't like, but heavy enough that I ain't got to worry about it. But my setup is perfect. You couldn't ask for a better setup the way this is set up. But I'm shooting a Bear Authority, believe it or not. I don't know if you can see the name. The name. I got it rigged up with Sims Vibration Limb Savers. Vibration Laboratory Limb Savers. Split limb dampeners. I've already got string dampeners already mounted onto the bow. That's what's factory done like that. That bow is quiet. I mean, some of these deer, people think that these deer jump these strings all the time. Well, I don't have a problem with that because my bow is so quiet. But I'm shooting a Trophy Ridge Whisker Biscuit Power Shot, I believe. Maybe Kill Shot, I don't remember which, but yeah. That's pretty much my setup. I'm about 15 to 16 foot up off the ground, maybe 17, give or take a couple, you know, whatever. But he's coming. But yeah, I mean, that's pretty much my whole setup. They just timbered this spring, which is, and a lot of this CRP from last year has been taken out. A lot of this was in CRP, so. What happened is that, because I helped my cousin Joe do it, it's forcing these deer to come right by us now, pretty much. I mean, they near as bad, but I'm going to get off of here. I hope to do another video when I'm down in the bottoms on my other spot that I've got pictures of 11 point. But I've been getting a lot of pictures off of this spot of different bucks. I've gotten some other ones. Been trying to kill Hit List. That's my giant buck. But I'm going to get off here and, yeah. My cousin's coming in trying to be sneaky. His Mossy Oak don't work too well. But, yeah. Real True Camo, Rage Broadheads, Carbon Express Arrows, Nocturnals, Luminox, Bear, Trophy Ridge. Yep. All of it. I'll see y'all later.